Bienvenidos, aloha, and welcome into Sunset Rewind. We provide the best in-depth coverage of high school football across the Sunset League. I'm your host, Alex Crawford, and alongside me, as always, former Oregon State tight end Howard Kroom. In our first episode, we recapped the COVID season, let you know which seniors got all-league honors, all-league awards, and honored them. But now, I'm excited, Howard. We're going to look forward. We're just over, barely over a month away from the fall 2021 season, so we're going to look at the underclassmen who got awards, who got all-league honors, and we're going to get you juiced for that 2021 season in the fall. Before we get into that, though, I do want to ask you, just off the bat, what are you most looking forward to with this fall season?
Yeah, well, you mentioned it. The underclassmen in the Sunset League absolutely showed out in the spring. The all first and second team all Sunset League teams were full of juniors, sophomores, even some freshmen in there. So there's a ton of talent all across the league. I'm really excited to see this season. But specifically, I'm looking forward to seeing these guys and these teams with an opportunity to go to the postseason. We have teams in Sunset League with CIF championship aspirations, and we have teams with state championship aspirations. So I'm really excited to get this full fall season underway and see how far the Sunset League can go after league play.
Well, let's start at the bottom of the ladder and work our way up. We'll go from Fountain Valley up to Los Al and let you know which returning players to keep your eyes on this fall, starting off with the Fountain Valley Barons. They were 0-6, but they had three underclassmen on first and second team All-Sunset League, Nick Mendez, Ben Pham, and Andrew Oliveris.
And all those guys, key contributors, obviously, to what the Barons do, but it's not just the all-league guys that they have coming back, coming in the fall 2021 season that Coach Anderson's excited about. There's also a couple of other guys. When we met with Coach, he mentioned Drew Reyes, going to be a two-year starter at wide receiver. He's a senior, a very steady, consistent guy for the Barons. Also, Kane Elroy, middle linebacker. He was young last year, but got a ton of reps. He's a leader. And then one of the questions, but somebody that Coach Anderson feels really strong about, is Owen Tomko, junior quarterback, so a new guy at the helm running the offense, but Coach Anderson has a ton of confidence in him, and I'm excited to see how these new integrations improve Fountain Valley.
This is a team that's going to be really junior-heavy this year, so this is a team that's going to be better this year, and they're going to be even better the next year. Let's move on to Huntington Beach. They had three first-team all-league underclassmen, Tyler Moses, Hideo Ray, and Rylan Vibbard. They were all juniors last year, and then they have four returning players who were second-team all-Sunset League.
Yeah, you know, Alex, I am so high on Hideo Ray Tyler Moses. Just from watching the game against Newport Harbor last year, both of those guys quickly became two of my favorite players in the Sunset League. Tyler Moses was the MVP for Huntington Beach, did everything that his team needed, including being an excellent punter.
Yes.
In addition to offense, yes, defense, so he's a stud. Hideo Ray, I loved everything that Hideo Ray did last year. He was kind of a bailout guy for Huntington Beach. When they needed a big play on offense or defense, he was the guy that they looked to. So they're returning some core pieces, but then you also mentioned the other second team all-league, or the other returning guys that Coach Brown has a lot of faith in. EJ Redrick, senior Mike linebacker, tough as nails, very fast kid, big part of the defense. AJ Vandermeid, another kid with great size. He was a sophomore last year, got a lot of good experience at safety and wide receiver, plays with a ton of confidence. Also leader of the offensive line, William Burke, and a young guy who was a sophomore last year that Coach is really excited about. He's going to be a junior inside linebacker, Nate Tawanu'u. Really excited to see him grow.
Yeah, I really believe, I'm not just drinking the orange and black Kool-Aid, I really believe in what Coach Brett Brown is doing there at Huntington Beach. I know he's been there for a while. He's been there for 16 years at the helm for six. They had that 2013 CIF championship. But when we're looking at Sunset League teams rising and falling, and we're talking about that preseason schedule, because obviously there's only six Sunset League teams, so there's a pretty hefty preseason, I look at Huntington Beach as a team that could surprise people this year. I know we're going to get into our full season prediction episode in a little bit, or a few episodes away, but I really look at the Oilers as a team that's got talent on their roster.
They definitely do, and another guy they're bringing back who's really going to help that consistency and their growth next year is AJ Perez. He was a junior quarterback last year. He split reps with the senior, but Coach Brown is really excited about him and really confident that he's the guy going into fall 2021.
Yeah, I'm excited to see what the Huntington Beach Oilers do in the fall. Let's go on to the team that we called games for, Newport Harbor. They finished 3-3. If we're talking about the Sailors, we got to start off talking about the Sunset League wide receiver of the year, Kashtan Hengem, as a sophomore. 50 catches, 700-plus yards, 5 touchdowns. Imagine that production over a full season. I cannot wait to see Cash Money's growth in this fall season.
Yeah, Cash and Hingham, just an incredible year as a sophomore last year. He's a big kid, really long, has good size, physicality at the line of scrimmage, and fights through contact to make catches. He's great on a deep ball, great at the high point, really, really reliable receiver. He's going to be a go-to guy for Nick Kim and Nick Kim's third year as the starting quarterback for Coach Lofthouse. They're going to have some fun stuff on the offense, and I'm excited to see what Coach Lofthouse has drawn up now that he has another year with these guys as veterans.
We also have to talk about one of the co-offensive linemen of the year, Grayson Simon, a junior last year coming back. He's got talks with San Jose State and some other top schools or some D1 programs, so he's a guy with a crazy motor on the offensive line. He's only going to improve. Really excited to see him anchoring that Newport Harbor Sailors O-line.
Yeah. In addition, I want to mention Josiah Lamarque, somebody we know is going to set the Sunset League on fire. Only a freshman last year, probably going to win Special Teams Player of the Year multiple times in Sunset League, maybe even a Receiver of the Year award as well. So just talent everywhere on this Newport Harbor team. And we didn't even mention Carson Diavola.
Connor Chenier. Well, they're both first-team All-League returners, and Diavola is the anchor of that defense, and we saw him lay hits last year.
And I couldn't think of it, but my guy Carlone, another freshman who's going to be a beast as a sophomore in Sunset League next year. So a lot to be excited about if you're Coach Lofthouse.
Yeah, there's pieces there for sure on Irvine Avenue for the Sailors, and obviously we're going to be calling games for them in the fall. Can't wait to see what they do in the Sunset League. Can they make the leap? Can they knock off the next team we're going to talk about, Corona Del Mar? They got it close. They only lost by 3 in the Battle of the Bay, the best showing in the Coach Lofthouse era. But CDM returns a lot of really good guys, too. Charlie Mannon, the first guy we got to mention, the only first-team All-Leaguer returning. And Coach Dan O'Shea talk about Mannon being an even better off-the-field guy than he is on the field, and he's an amazing on-the-field player for the Sea Kings.
Well, and you mentioned it last episode. The Sea Kings won a state championship, a league championship, a CIF championship, and a state championship in 2019. Coming back the following year, people thought it was a rebuilding year. It wasn't. All they did was reload. There was a sophomore at quarterback, David Razor. There was a sophomore at running back, Evan Sanders. Both of those guys got All-League honors. As sophomores, no spring ball, no summer training. So they're going to look to make huge leaps. A lot of contributors coming back. And one thing we love, we always talk about, Dan O'Shea, he's a culture guy.
Yes.
He's a we, not me.
Chase the ring.
That's their mentality. They're set up to do some really strong things this year in the league, and they're going to challenge for that for the crown at the top of the Sunset League.
Absolutely. I mean, he talked about the guys come in every day. Like you said, it's we, not me. They're not allowed to say I. They're not allowed to say me. It has to be we. It has to be us. And they talk about chasing the ring every day. They tap the sign that says chase the ring. When you have a culture like that, that's a team that can go up and compete with Los Al, can compete with anyone year in, year out.
Well, and you combine that with the talent. We talked about Razor and Sanders on the offensive side, who were young guys that got all league last year. On the defensive side, you got Gavin Scott and Dylan Wood on the D-line. You also have Jake Simpkins in the defensive backfield. So you take that culture, you combine it with the talent. It's going to be a really tough team to get out in Sunset League.
7 second-team all-league guys returning for the Sea Kings. Let's go up to the team that finished second in the Sunset League, the Edison Chargers. We got to start off talking about Sunset League Offensive Player of the Year, wide receiver, now a senior, Nico Brown.
I don't know how many people knew about Nico Brown coming into the season, but he tore it up. He put everybody on notice, not just in Sunset League, in the entire Orange County area. Nico Brown was a beast last year. Excellent receiver, complete receiver. Coach told us he works at his weaknesses. He's hungry. Coach Grady told us that this offseason, Nico Brown is standing out as a guy who's put in a ton of work to transform his body and to come into his senior season and put up even better numbers and make an even bigger impact than he did as the Offensive Player of the Year as a junior.
Offensive Player of the Year as a junior. So what's he going to do in his senior year? And that's why Edison, of course, is going to be a threat. On the defensive side, they're anchored by first-team All-League defensive end Austin Gribbick, who we know is just a terror out there on the D-line. We saw him in the club football level of the Sunset Argonauts, and then we saw him in the Sunset League. Just unstoppable, really.
Austin Gribbick had an excellent junior year, just a menace on the D-line. He's long and athletic, has a great pass rush, also physical, powerful, uses his hands well, gets after it, pursues to the ball. He's a great defensive end and needs to put a little size on in this offseason, but I think he's going to make some noise and have some college coaches calling him after they see what he does this fall.
Other first-team All-League selections for the Edison Chargers, Troy Fletcher, Jackson Graff, and Hudson Letterman. Let's move on to Los Alamitos, the reigning Sunset League champions, a team we're so bummed we couldn't see what they did beyond the Sunset League. We're going to get to see it this year. 9 returning players who are either first team or second team all Sunset League, and they have the most dangerous duo in the county, one of the most dangerous duos in the country at quarterback Malachi Nelson and wide receiver Makai Lemon. They're just going to be juniors this year. They were sophomores last year, and they were co-league MVPs.
Right. You just asked the question a minute ago. If you did all that as a junior or a sophomore, what the heck are you going to do next year?
Yeah.
But everybody thinks that these guys, they're not even close to their ceiling. They haven't met their potential. As you said, only sophomores, didn't get spring ball, didn't get summer training, didn't have any real time to get acclimated to the varsity level, and they still came out and tore it up. And they're going to be really special in 2021 and 2022.
Yeah, no, they're popping, man. Like I'm so excited to see what they do now in a full season. And when we went to meet with the Los Al coaching staff, we saw them come into the football office in their time off, in their free time, drawing up plays on the whiteboard, just putting in that extra work. And they're special. That's what it takes to be that extra special talent.
And co-defensive coordinator Coach Cobley told us that these are guys, even though they were sophomores, they were leaders on this team. They put in the work, as you said, and they're great kids off the field. So they're the kind of kids that you want to root for. And what's great about having high-profile recruits in your conference is every team gets to play against them, so every team's going to have eyes on them from college coaches.
Let's talk about co-defensive back of the year, Lane Broderick, co-offensive lineman of the year, Cash Kepka, and co-defensive lineman of the year, Adam Tomchek. Those are all going to be seniors for Los Al. So we're talking about they're losing a little bit at the linebacker position, and they're fully loaded everywhere else.
Yeah, fully loaded. These guys aren't just winning all-league honors. They're winning player of the year honors, and they're coming back, which means they have that much more confidence, that much more experience. And they just played a season a few months ago, so they're going to feel like they're still in a groove. So we already know Los Al, they're going to be a tough, tough out for everybody, not just in Sunset League, but in the entire area.
The last Los Al player who got an All-League award was Gavin Porch, All-Purpose Player of the Year. As a sophomore last year, he averaged 7 yards a carry, 3 rushing TDs, and 3 receiving TDs. So just another threat, another weapon for Malachi Nelson, and another guy to help take some of the pressure off Makai Lemon there at the wide receiver position.
Well, and there's so many other guys that when we sat down with Coach Cobley, he talked to us about that are going to be huge contributors. A guy like Brian Girardo comes to my mind. Mm-hmm. So many guys that he mentioned that are going to make contributions, but might not be all league, might not get all the bright lights. So there's talent everywhere for Los Al Griffins.
I don't want to make the prediction yet, but I'm going to. I know we're going to do our prediction show. It's way too early, but I'm going to go out on a limb and say I don't think anybody in the Sunset League is beating the Griffins this year. I'll be shocked if anybody beats them in the regular season at all. They are, the Los Alamitos Griffins are, my way too early Sunset League champion prediction choice.
So for me, making a prediction, it's tough. You know, there's great coaches up and down the league. I mean, looking at Coach Brown at Huntington Beach, steady as can be, knows how to win. I would trust him with my football life. Love what he's doing over there. Coach Anderson at Fountain Valley, building a program. He's doing everything the right way. He's the right guy for the job. Just needs a little bit more time. Going to Coach Lofthouse at Newport Harbor, an absolute offensive genius, can draw up a play against any defense and be successful. He's got the program going in the right direction. I love what they're doing. They're going to win a ton of games in the fall of 2021. Of course, we got Coach O'Shea at CDM, the definition of a winning culture. Everything that Coach O'Shea tells his guys is a selfless message, and it's about the team. It's about chasing the ring. Right now, as we sit here, I'm ready to run through a wall for Coach O'Shea. He's going to have his guys ready to play. They might win the league. Going over to Los Al, Coach Fenton, Coach Cobley, they're so experienced. They have a ton of talent. Their coaching staff, they got a ton of talent. So obviously, they're going to be the favorites to win the league. But for me, personally, I'm going with Coach Grady and the Edison Chargers as my 2021 Sunset League champions. I love what Coach Grady's doing. He has me believe that even though we're getting in a new quarterback at Edison, even though we have to replace the offensive line, I believe that the culture they have in place and the athletes with Nico Brown and the other receivers that they have returning, they're going to be tough. And I think that after going through that 5 overtime game against CDM, only losing to Los Al by 7, they're going to be hungry and they're going to take that Sunset League crown from Los Alamitos this season.
You heard it here first. Way too early prediction. Howard Kroom, Edison Chargers, Alex Crawford, Los Alamitos Griffins. We're going to do our season preview show We're going to make more in-depth predictions later on before the season starts. And I like that you're riding with the Edison Chargers. I mean, I believe in what all these coaches are doing. I'm glad you ran through all the coaches because I really do believe in these six head coaches and their staffs here at the Sunset League. A lot of experience. I mean, Coach Grady, guy was an offensive coordinator at Fresno State. I mean, that's top. That's top talent. And I wouldn't be surprised if Coach Fenton in the next couple of years got some calls from some top D1 programs.
Well, one of the main things, in addition to all of that football wealth of knowledge that you just talked about, that's evident from these coaches throughout the Sunset League, after we met with them, we left saying, man, these kids are in good hands. All of these student-athletes are with coaches that believe in character. They're not about self. They're about the team. And all of them have a ton of football experience. So it's a really, really strong group. And in my estimation, Sunset League football is in great hands. And this is the perfect time for us to be covering the league because it's on the rise and it's only going to continue to grow.
Well, that's a good segue into follow us on social media at Sunset_Rewind. We're going to have a ton of content for you. There's going to be some on there already, but we're going to have a ton coming up this fall. Videos, recaps, scores, everything you need at Sunset_Rewind. And in the fall, we're going to have an awesome website, sunsetrewind.com. That's going to be your go-to hub for all things Sunset League. And big thanks to GoldenCom for helping us build that website. If your website isn't working as hard as you want it to, you got to go to GoldenCom. They'll get you dialed in. I can't wait to debut that website for everyone, Howard.
We'll be here all fall, Saturday morning. You want to see the stats, you want recaps, come to sunsetrewind.com. We'll be here for you, bringing the most in-depth, comprehensive coverage of Sunset League football.
Well, Howard, for all our viewers, for all the parents, players, and coaches in the Sunset League, for our crew here at the Sunset Rewind Studio, and for my co-host, Howard Kroom, this is Alex Crawford saying from Saddleback to the Pacific Ocean, from PCH to the 405, you've been watching Sunset Rewind. Thanks for tuning in.